Light Oil, and we're wishing Sounds a very, very happy 10th birthday.
Alison Ware, and I'd like to wish Don and...
...to have people in, actually meeting people in the studio, other than the boys, the dreaded boys on the floor, who give me heaps. You see that at home sometimes? Oh, you notice how they give me heaps? Do you guys remember ABBA? Stuff like that?
Yeah!
Sherbet? Sherbet?
Yeah!
I'll do the directing, please. Unless it's the captain. She wants Fleetwood Mac. Cap, can we slip that in later? I don't think so. Oh, the captain will try. You too? Oh, they're specials. They're specials. No worries. Now, listen, if I can very quickly, in hospital at the moment is a little jockey mate of mine who broke his pelvis recently, and now he's got appendicitis. So, and he had it while he had the pelvis broken. They didn't realise it. So he's been through a lot of pain. Mickey Hood, get well as soon as you can. And also, a quick hello to Matt Ponsonby's daughter. Matt is a radio man. Kathy Ponsonby and all the girls from 7th year. Bless you. Thank you for watching on this day. Okay, Graham Webb was the man that started this show. He produced it. He devised it 2 years before this show actually started. We will watch Graham now. There he is in the audience. We'll talk to him later. But here he is first, with ABBA.
And it was your delivery that brought you to the world. And international recognition, wasn't
yes,
it?
Yes, it was. Yes.
I was the first guy to play Waterloo.
Me up in a balloon, and some crazy things have happened over the years, so we might, after we have a look at this man, Alan Lancaster from Status Quo, who I'll talk to shortly, we may go to some of the crazy things that we've done on Sounds. Alan, are you in there? Yes, there he is. Good on you, mate. Thanks for coming in. We will get you on set shortly and chat with you. But now, those crazy little things that have happened over the years on Sounds. Take it away. Just some strange...
Good morning, everyone. I'm
Dudley Sutherland.
As you well
it
know,
is.
We are here on Drake
Keppel Island. A little bit windy, but we're going to have a lot of fun. In the next 3 hours, we'll bring you all the musical fantasies you would ever...
You plan, boss. You plan.
You took me for a spin. Feels like about 2 minutes ago, but it was actually about an hour ago. And we went and took a camera with us, actually caught a whole stack of the track. So what I want to do, I've got a map here. And if I ask you the speeds that you would do at different times, will you fill us in as we go? For a start, you take off at the start. Now, what would you be doing when you hit Hell's Corner?
Probably about 85, 90 miles per hour.
So you're already into 90 mile an hour. What about along Mountain Straight?
You'd get up possibly to 120, 130 miles an hour.
We weren't quite doing that, were we? We're going to be talking to Rene Geyer, Shelley Strawn, B. Birtles, Derek Polici out of Little River Van, Cliff Richard will be on the show, Max Merritt, and a whole lot more. Part of our Sounds in London show. We're here in Piccadilly Circus with three of the guys out of madness. Who better to tell us where we are and all about it? What is Piccadilly Circus? Explain.
Piccadilly Circus, you may well ask. You're a tourist, aren't you? You're a bit of a foreigner. Well, there we are. For all your Australians back home, this is real culture. This is real history in the making.
Why?
Okay, well, Eros here points towards Hungary, where England played their first World Cup match in 1875. Yes.
We're on Great Keppel Island. You're watching Sounds. Keep doing it. Come on, boys, let's get going.
Fellas, no! Mark Knopfler, he's going home. Thanks. I knew there was a trap.
And the winner is... Best TV compare, Donny Sutherland from Sound Unlimited.
Welcome to Sound Unlimited. Today.
He just doesn't believe it.
Well, you beat out some good ones, Donnie.
Hello, Marcia. Thank you very much. No, I just don't believe it. Graham Webb, who's done a mighty job with the voiceovers. I don't feel as nervous as I did earlier. Thank you to everyone that voted. Thank you to my mum. Hey, mum, at home. Sorry I didn't bring you down for this, but I didn't think we'd stand a chance. Thank you to Graham himself, who put me on telly in the first place. To Harry Widmer. To all my friends, relatives, and all those, again, who voted, thank you. God bless you.
God love you, Donny.
I'd like to thank Donny on behalf of all of those who appear on his show. Thank you very much for the opportunity to present such great music to Australia. Thank you, Donny.
Sound Unlimited's Donny Sutherland.
And there's me mum now. I brought her down for this one. Robbie Porter was on that. Robbie, if you're watching...
Yeah. anniversary. And Donnie, go for 10 more.
This is Mick from the Solid Citizens. A couple of members there. Look, I love the suits. Where did you get them?
We got them ordered, I suppose.
Where from?
Friend of ours in Darlinghurst.
So it wasn't a Brisbane outfit that you brought down?
Well, yeah, it is a Brisbane outfit, but not the band.
I see. It's a Brisbane band?
Yeah.
But not the suits, you
mean? Yeah, that's right.
Yes. Can I just read a few lines? No, well, I'll start up here. MP in New UK Secretary. Oh, we'll get past that. Mrs. You're right. No, I think I'll leave them to you. You'll have a new single out shortly to follow up singing in the shower.
Yeah, we've got a new one coming out in about 3 weeks.
Good, look forward to it. And welcome to Sydney. Now, the boys that will be supporting Twisted Sister. Yeah. What is that? Boss of the group. Thank you, Ian, fellas. You've got something there. We'll pass it on as quick as you can.
Happy birthday again.
Yeah, it's been great.
Don't open this card unless you'd like to get a little birthday wish. I get you. Thank you, boss, very much for being in here. And I'll get no further on that one. Righto, 1982 it is. We're on Sounds for our 10th birthday. Men at Work first. Them Culture Club, remember them? And Moving Pictures coming in. Men at Work first. Let's go down under. Good boys.
From a man in Brussels. He was 6'4". Full of muscle. I said, do you speak my language? He just smiled and gave me a Vegemite sandwich. And he said, I come from a land of love. From Peter's Flow and mentioned her. Can't you hear the thunder? You better run, you better take cover.
From old 55, still going strong. How many years is it now, Rocky?
10 years now, Donnie.
10, so you've basically started at the same time as
Yeah, basically around the same time, yeah.
Yeah? And you still work the same sort of songs, or do you do new material?
We do. Well, we like to play our hits, you know, because people expect that to hear those. So but we've got some new original stuff coming up. And we
two questions. Old 55, how many hits?
11. Okay. 11 singles.
FJ Holden, what's he doing these days?
Well, Frank's doing a bit of acting, a few ads. You've probably seen him on some of the ads. And I think he's singing in Melbourne at the moment, too, with a few bands and local
If you
bands.
See him, would have loved to have had him on the show.
Yeah. Mm.
Thank you very much for coming in. Right. Pat and Rockpile from Old 55. Now we'll go to a newie from Pat Benatar, the Ooh Ooh song. First time played in Australia. We thought, well, why not do something like that on our 10th birthday? So we are. Ooh Ooh song, Pat Benatar. Next special guest is the man that is responsible for actually starting this show. He had his own video show first in Australia 2 years before this one started 10 years ago. And when it came the first day of colour, he actually was nice enough to let me take over as compere. He became producer 10 years ago. Graham Webb.
Well, the truth was, Donnie, you were the best star guest I had all that year of 74 through to 70.
Thank you.
3 through 74.
I love that. Let's move past that. How did you come up? How did you come up with the idea of starting a video show?
Well, I was travelling around Europe and around the world, and I saw all these TV shows, pop TV shows, and I figured there's some way to get a grab out of each one of those. And I came back home and found that there was a way of beg, borrowing and stealing little bits of songs from everybody, including there were a couple of clips around at that stage. As you know, you have them in your library.
Yeah.
But I think when I first started the first show, we had 25 clips only, and that's all we had in the library.
And you actually started a series of shows with 25 clips.
That's how we started.
So what happened if you hadn't have got Russell Mulcahy to come and make some clips for you quickly? You would have run out after the first
week. That's right. So yeah. I got guys like Russell Mulcahy, paid him $80 to do it.
$80,
yeah, yeah.
Russell?
Yeah, he was a good fellow.
If only we could get him for that now. What do you reckon? $80. What does he charge? $1 million or something?
Such an essential thing, though, the video now, as regards the combination with the music.
You created what is called the 80s phenomenon.
The first pop
television. You can read all about it in Rock Video.
What, do they mention me in there?
New magazine out this week, and I mention you in my column.
Thank you,
$2. Was launched on Thursday.
No, it's been great. It's been a great 12 years, but great 10 years with you, mate.
Thank you, mate.
Thank you.
Thank you for my life for the last 10. You and God are the two that I thanked last night. 1983. Irene Cara, Michael Jackson, I mean that, and Ostentatious. Three big hits out of 1983. 10 years of sounds. The baby of Graham Webb. We thank you.
Thank you, guys.
I can't have it. Just then Warra comes out of the kitchen with a few drinks for everybody. Fair dinkum, you've never seen a cooler barmaid. I grabbed a beer and said, thanks, Warra, ta. A couple of Queensland at the party, one smelling pretty strongly of aftershave. He sat down next to me, I turned to him, I said, you know, mate, you reek of stockade. It was a really hot day. Oscar felt like a swim. He said to Ina, you want to have a dip in the river, Ina? She said, I haven't got my cozzy, Oscar. Well, Bo says, come in stark as Waddle Lake hair. Ina says, what, without so much as a thread, Bo?
Some more hits on sounds. From 1983. What a big year that was. Good on you, Ostentatious. I know he's somewhere in the country, I think in Melbourne at the moment, and couldn't be here today. Now, our next guest, Bob Hughes from 2Day FM in Sydney. You started off on Sounds, well, Sound Unlimited, it was called 10 years ago, and you were doing record reviews. Just go through the stations you've been to since then.
Festival Records I worked for a while, and right. Then 2NX, 2KA, 2WS, 2MMM. And the pinnacle of my success today, FM. Typical radio career, I'd say.
And you're killing them now, and you've done a great job, and congratulations for
that. Congratulations to you on your 10 years.
Thank you. Pierre's here. Put your hands together for Pierre from Pseudo Echo. Pierre, what's the scene with records at this moment? Is another one about to come out, isn't it?
Yeah, the middle of April. We've been in the studio through the last week or so.
Who is producing this new
This one here, Joe Wizard. Boss Gag, Silt Degrees.
All right.
Earth, Wind and Fire.
So it'll be called, and when does it come out?
Living in a Dream, and around the middle of April.
Okay, the next Pseudo Echo single. Thank you for coming in, Ross Wilson. Thank you, mate. Ross the Boss, we call him in Australia. Don't worry about the other fella. He's the boss. We will be back in a minute to talk with Ross, JPY, and a couple of other people. Thanks for being here, Ross. He's staying with us. Right now, we'll have a look at Diana Ross and Missing You. On our 10th anniversary sound show, it is lovely to be with you on a Saturday morning. As always, it's just got to become a normal thing, isn't it? I just couldn't do anything else. I wouldn't go to the races.
Since you've been away, I've been down and lonely. Since you've been away, I've been thinking of you. Trying to understand the reason you left me. What were you going through? Ooh, ooh, I'm missing you. Tell me why the road turns. Ooh, ooh, I'm missing you. Tell me why the road turns.
Tell me why the road turns.
want to wish Donnie and Sounds a very, very happy 10th birthday, and I hope you keep rocking for another 10 years. Rock out.
To my soul.
On our 10th birthday. Aha. A very quick happy birthday to Cameron from 2CC in Canberra, and hi to all those people in Canberra. Now, on the set, we'll go. Mark, what am I talking about? Harv and Rick from the Divinals. Then we'll go Mark. Where's Mark? Ganga Jang. John Paul Young's in the centre. And down here, Ross Wilson. I should have really set that up, shouldn't I? Yeah. Boys, thank you for coming in on our birthday, and you will stay for the party that's happening. If I could stay with a couple of the guys that have been in the heavyweight division for the 10 years, JPY, the lightweight, in height and everything, and Ross Wilson, Ross the Boss, as we call him, can you just pick out one band around at the moment that is young that you really think have another 10 years in them? Just one off the top of the head.
That's a difficult prediction. I think anybody last 10 years has got to have something really good.
What do you think it was that made you last 10 years?
I don't like to starve, you know.
So you worked a lot.
So I've got a reason to keep going. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Jono, is there one around that you think definite?
Well, I think it's always a problem with bands. Musical differences is such a...
Yeah.
Especially after about 3 years, that's usually when it sets in and people start clawing at each other.
Which becomes
a personality problem. For a band to stay together.
So you won't predict?
No, but I do like I'm Talking at the moment.
Uh-huh. What about music over the last 10 years? Has it improved?
Yeah, everything improves.
Yeah?
Yeah.
With it's age? Always,
yeah.
Like a good old wine. All right.
Like a good old wind.
We will now have a look at songs out of 1984, just last year. Dancing in the Dark, Bruce Springsteen, another boss. Then the 12th Man, and then Ray Parker Jr.
There's a joke, it's a while, and it's on me. I shake this world off my shoulders. Come on, baby, the laugh's on me. Stay on the streets of this town, and they'll be carving you up all right. Say you gotta stay hungry. Hey baby, I'm just a fast star in the night. I'm dying for some action. I'm sick of sitting around here trying to write this book. I need a little reaction. Come on, baby, give me just one look. We can't start a fire. Sitting around crying over a broken heart. This gun's for hire. We're just dancing in the dark. We can't start a fire. Worried about your little world falling apart. This gun's for hire. Even if we're just dancing in the dark. Even if we're just dancing in the dark.
And let's take a look at the card now. And you'll see there that they started off reasonably well. The opening pair of He's a Has-Been and Nidra Fascars put on 29 runs before Geoffrey Lawson claimed the first. The next man in was Peanut Butter Jars. He joined Darbrake Meandad out there in the centre with the score at just 4 for 60. But he's been horribly out of form, Peanut Butter Jars, and this partnership only took the score along to 71 before Peanut Butter Jars became the fifth wicket to fall for Pakistan when he was caught in the gully by Hughes off the bowling of Rackerman. It's a good effort, that, and the Australians were understandably quite ecstatic out there.
If you're seeing things running through your head, who can you call?
Ghostbusters!
An invisible man sleeping in your bed. Oh, who you gonna call?
Hi, this is Ray Parker Jr., and you're looking at Sounds with Donnie.
I hear it likes the girls.
7 staff, the captain upstairs, and in particular, the Channel 7 management. Thank you very much for a great 10 years, and also in particular, the record companies, the media, and everybody at home. Thanks for putting up with us for 10 years. Hope you can do it again for another 10. Let's go out with this one, A Little Beauty. I love it. It was last year's biggest song.